floating crystals. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. Something's blocking it. Thank you.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world, in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life, popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there's something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
Evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Carla Vaughn. The questions asked here correspond to the fifth iteration of the Gunner's psychological assessment. Are you ready, Dylan? Let's begin then. In a single word, describe the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling, he is out of the building today.
He's never out. He didn't want to come, did he? He never visits, not since Roberts. Tell Darling it wasn't my fault. I couldn't control it yet, but... I can now. I learned. Will you tell him?
In a single word, describe the world around you.
A prison. A cold, empty prison. Not even a poster on the wall.
Okay. What is the next number in the sequence 3, 6, 9, 12, 15?
18.
What day is it today?
How the hell would I know? It's not like you give me a calendar.
You find a rabbit in the woods. It is breathing, but not moving. You cannot see any blood. What do you do?
Leave it.
Expand on that.
It doesn't matter. The rabbit's not real. None of it's real.
What day is it today?
Do you enjoy asking people questions that can't be answered? Is this what gets you up in the morning? What you dreamed of doing as a scared, stupid little girl?
Can you describe a dog to me?
In ordinary, we had a friend. Nosebleed Neil. And when it all went crazy, you know what I mean. Nosebleed Neil turned into a dog. Or something like a dog.
What day is it tomorrow?
Fuck off! I don't know! There is no calendar! How can I fucking know?
Dylan, calm down.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck Casper! Hey! Are you watching this, you old fuck? Did you send your bitch because you're too scared of me? Where is Casper?
Security, get a team in here. I need...
Thank you.
see what they had on Ordinary. It's all here. Our home, our school, the woods, the dump.
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes. Beyond the shadow you settle for, there's a miracle illuminated. I looked the poem up.
Only I couldn't find any poet by that name. I did find a European filmmaker who moved here in the 60s, named Thomas Zane.
What?
No matter. It suits you very well, the poem. How you see things. Maybe you wrote it yourself?
I didn't.
No matter. You've said a few times that you feel like there's a piece of you missing. Can we talk about that?
Okay. Yeah, it's this. I feel an emptiness, a yearning for something that I think I lost.
It's natural for you to feel that way. Your brother and your parents are dead.
No! No! Dylan's not dead. And that's not even it.
You're referring to the imaginary friend from your childhood?
Polaris. She's come back. After a long time, she's calling me. In a dream I saw, she showed me things.
Jesse.
It felt more real than anything. As real as what happened in Ordinary.
The industrial accident in your hometown? That you believe Polaris caused?
No! It wasn't an accident! There was no industrial accident, and Polaris didn't cause it! She saved me and Dylan.
Jesse.
No! It was a cover-up. The government knows about it. There were agents there. Agents from, I don't know exactly, but they took Dylan. I'll find them. I won't stop looking. Polaris wants me to go to New York. There's a building there. I have to leave soon. I have to be there at a very specific time. Something hugely important is going to happen.
Jesse, you know we can't let you go until you're well. And that begins by understanding what's real and what's imagined.
Landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable. pretty unbelievable.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. Dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.
Contact the janitor if you need to get through.
Broken? How many dead ends can this place have? We need to find Ati. No Ati. Where is he?
Now this boy left, said the son of Annikki Tähti. My assistant will keep Berg in the glove and the house standing. Lomille lumps, holiday humps.
How can anyone even get out of here while the building's sealed? Let alone go on a holiday. In here too?
Thank you. kolmesta kahdeksaan, ajoittain noin 10 metriä sekunnissa. Illalla tuuli heikkenee. Itämeri, etelä-Lounaanmeri, 5-2 kohtaa, noin 14 metriä sekunnissa. Päivällä ja illalla suunnaltaan vaihtelevaa tuulta, 6-10 metriä sekunnissa, yöllä tuuli väliaikaisesti. Hyvä näkyvyys. Selkämeren pohjoisosa, meren kulku ja perämeri suunnaltaan vaihtelevaa tuulta 3-6 metriä sekunnissa. Ja hyvä näkyvyys. Sää rannikkoa.
Something up ahead. Do you see it?
Hey, girl. For a fin, holidays home.
Did you miss me? Did you have peace in your sock?
Yes.
No. Park, don't make a wound. You did good. Take my cassette player. You can borrow it. The song is a present from my friends to you. It will get you through the maze so you can do your job.
Of course it did. He gave me his cassette player. It'll get me through the maze, huh? The janitor always has the keys.
Control. the expedition into Slidescape 36. What Darling brought back changed everything.
Finding the projector was how this all began. What started in ordinary ends here. You, me, Dylan. We've all come full circle. There was a doorway here, to where Dylan and I went, where the projector took us, where we met you. The Bureau opened the same door here, but there's just an echo now. Are you close? Just on the other side? Not here. Moved again. What did Darling do with it? I've got to find out.
The projected image from each slide is a physical portal into another dimension. Only one slide remains. Dylan's sister burned the rest in ordinary before we could intercept. The text on it, color slide film, this side towards screen, and the number 36. The topography of Slidescape 36 bears deep wave marks. On the slide and in the distance, there's a formation of five pillars, like crude, outstretched fingers. There were casualties on our first expedition. Communication is an issue. There is no sound there, as if you've gone deaf. And radios don't work. Correction, a resonance from an unknown source, in part within the range of audible frequency. It acts in unpredictable ways, causing feedback loops that can tear you apart. Trench insists he heard something else. It made his ears bleed. Our equipment found no evidence of anything beyond the primary resonance. Trench's medical tests show nothing amiss. The projected image from each slide is a physical portal into another dimension. Only one slide remains. Dylan's sister burned the rest in ordinary before we could intercept. The text on it, color slide film, this side towards screen, and the number 36. The topography. Thank you. Expedition 3. We located the source of the resonance in Slidescape 36. It is an entity, a living organism of a considerable mass. I've named it Hedron based on its physical shape.
Hedron?
We built a container for it.
Was that you? Did he bring you here? Is that why you brought me here? You're here. You're here. They have you. I know you. I remember her from Ordinary. I thought I'd never see you again. Hang on, I'm coming.
I'm Dr. Casper Darling, and this is my final message. It's not the end. But after this, I won't. I exposed myself to Hedron resonance fully. It's changing me. I've seen. Shown so much. Slidescape 36 was where Hedron stopped the spread of another. It's terrifying. It really is. It's another source of resonance. Trench was exposed to this other. It will now spread. I've done everything I can to stop the Hedron resonance amplifiers. I don't know if it'll make a difference. I won't be here when it happens. I should have told him anymore. I'm being sent one more lesson. Something wonderful, I think.
Here? You are coming through so strong. Darling used this HRA to lock the door. I have to rip it off to get in. Are you sure? Okay, I'll be there. Hang on. I made it.
The hole in your room is a hole in you. You gave it, we let you into the hole in you! You have always been here. The only child, a copy of a copy of a copy!
No. Why did you... This was a mistake.
Thank you.
poster comes down and there's nothing there. It's just the cell and death. I was wrong. There was never anything there.
Hello? Polaris, are you there? Please. Okay, I'm not so
Please sleep.
Please.
I just want to sleep. Never let me sleep.
You are a worm through time. The thunder song distorts you. Happiness comes. Light curls the veil.
She's a worm, makes me feel these ways. He's a worm, needs some rays. Can't stand the film, hate the film. Gone insane, hijack a plane. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. Trying hard to lose my head. Can hardly breathe. I've been insane. Just my ventilate. Can hardly breathe.
Good help.
Federal Bureau of Control, how may
I
help you?
I need those field reports typed up and in management's hands first thing tomorrow.
The Bureau's the best at what it does. Protecting everyday Americans from foreign threats.
There's the new girl, standing around daydreaming, and she should be getting work done. Who the hell does she think she is? The director? Thank you for giving me a chance.
Why do they keep you around?
I'm sorry. Anything for the Bureau.
Fine. Get out of here.
Thank you for giving me a chance. Anything for the Bureau.
The nerve of this woman.
Who does she think she is?
Someone has to take it to him.
Better her than me.
Are you sure you are not lost? Maybe you can find yourself in the director's office.
Oh, great. I was just waiting for you. Please, take the outgoing mail as well.
What? What is happening? I don't like this. No, this isn't me. I'm not me. I can't. You. Oh, I've forgotten something. I can't think. Oh, I'm lost. Oh, where are you? I can't feel anything. I don't want to be alone here. Where am I? What is this? Why won't it end? Wake up, please. I want to go home.
You should keep trying. You are getting closer.
I need to go inside. I need to keep moving.
I must act.
I won't let them win. That's how it happened. The hiss got Trench first. He turned on the projector. He let them in. I have to remember the hiss. The hiss is the enemy. This is all inside my head. The hiss burrowing in. I'm trapped in here. They're taking over. None of this is real. I will fight this. I will find a way to push them out.
Welcome back. I knew I chose a good assistant.
I need my gun.
You are a worm through time. The thunder saw storms you.
I know what I must do. Start at the beginning. I should have seen it earlier. This is my mess to clean up. My fight. No one else's.
I am the director.
Hello. This is Dr. Casper Darling. I have a classified message for the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. I have sad news. Hedren is gone now, but it was not a source. It was a catalyst. Do you understand? You must go to my office, the Endgame. It will be revealed.
I can't feel you. I can't. This is what Dylan wanted all along. But there is something. I can feel it, but I don't know what. The motel is a place of power, of change, a place to pass through, connecting everything. This is a dream inside my head. Why shouldn't it take me anywhere I want to go? Really? This is so weird. But it is my head. You are such a weirdo, Jesse. Hedren is dead, but you're alive here in me. Maybe Hedren put you in our heads when we met her. Maybe you were always there, and she was just trying to teach me how to trigger you. Maybe I'll never understand. Maybe I don't need to. Trench was the first to be corrupted by the hiss. Slowly, over the years. His need for control only made it worse. It was Trench who took the projector to the nostalgia department. He opened the door to the hiss. Just like that. With Hedren dead, the hiss tried to corrupt me too. But I'm stronger than them. We're stronger. They're waiting. They'll try to stop us.
My sister had this dream. A bad dream. And the whole world was dreaming with her.
Dylan?
She convinced herself that she was awake. She's always been stubborn. I had to end her dream. I had to wake her up. Rip down the poster she'd been staring at. Cut off her eyelids to make her see. To save her.
You are worth your time. The thunder song distorts you. Happiness comes white curls, but yellow and red in the eye.
I know he's still there somewhere. Locked inside. I know, because that's how it was for me.
Thank you.
home. You remind us of home. You've taken your boss. Your boss. You.
Dylan's in a coma. I don't know if there's anything of him left in there. If he'll ever find his way back. The portal's been closed, but the hiss is still in the oldest house. And the lockdown can't be lifted as long as any trace of it remains. I'm working on a solution with my management team, but there is still a long road ahead. I'm the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. We're in this together. You and I.